नमस्ते, वेलकम बैक टू माय वीडियोस। आई एम राजशेखर, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर फ्रॉम इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज बीकानेर। एक्चुअली यस्टरडे, आई मीन प्रीवियस क्लास, वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट अरेज। व्हाट इज एन अरे, हाउ टू डिक्लेयर एन अरे, हाउ वी कैन गिव द इनपुट्स, हाउ वी कैन प्रिंट द आउटपुट्स फ्रॉम अरे, व्हाट इज एन इंडेक्स, हाउ द इंडेक्स वैल्यू विल बी स्टार्ट, आई मीन how we can represent the value or how we can change the values in an array. Already we have discussed. But today, we can continue the topic, same like the arrays. But here, today I will introduce about different types of arrays. Means arrays we have to declare in different types. Like I actually yesterday, in previous lecture, I have discussed about a single dimensional array. Actually, we can represent the data in the form of multi-dimensional in a programming language by using arrays. Multi-dimensional means dimension means in x and y directions, that is called one dimension. Same like yesterday, we have done the declaration array only single dimension, means we have represented the data in the form of rows only. I can represent in the form of data matrix also, means columns and rows. So you can represent the data in the form of two dimensional, that is called columns and rows. You can represent the data in the form of multidimensional, means columns and rows and the type of matrices, different matrices we can represent, that is called the multidimensional or three dimensional arrays. So today we can see two dimensional, three dimensional arrays, how we can represent the types of arrays, and I can give an example. Let's see the examples. Here, multidimensional array. How we can represent the multidimensional array is in C programming or any programming language. In C programming, we can create an array of arrays. You can create an array of arrays. These arrays are known as the multidimensional arrays. Means, actually yesterday we have discussed only up to here. Means float x of 3, float is the data type. X is the name of the array and 3 is the size of that array. But I am representing array of another array. So here 4 is taking an extra, that is called the another array, means another data in that array. Okay. So these type of declaration or these type of arrays are called, we can call the multidimensional array. Multidimensional means more than one dimension, that we can call the multidimensional. Here the 3 can represent here the rows. The data in the form of rows, here 4 here represent the data in the form of columns. For example, if you want to do matrices to represent the matrices, if you want to do addition of matrices or the multiplication or different operations you want to do on the top matrices, you can follow these type of declarations, means the multidimensional arrays. Here, how the data can be stored in your database. If you are using in C programming, database means in your program, like this. Column 1, what is this? X00 means x 0 from here and 0 here. Next x01, x02, x03. So these 3 are the rows. Okay, these 4 are the columns. Columns, 4 columns. Like this, if you want to present any data in your program, you can use this multidimensional arrays. So this is the process for declaring a multidimensional array. Means data type, same like that, array name, more than two dimensions. Actually yesterday we have declared, I mean previous lecture we have declared only a single slice, but here I am using two slices with sizes. Okay, you can use the size based on your data, otherwise you can use without size also. Already we have discussed, I will show how to initialize this type of, how to declare this type of data in your program. Yeah, previously we have seen that two multidimensional arrays, but that is called the two dimensional array, because of we are taking the two dimensions, one is the rows and second one is the columns. You can represent the arrays by using three dimensional also. How we can represent three dimension? 2, 4 and 3. Means you have to contain two rows, four columns and each one we have to maintain three items. So how many total we are holding the elements? 24 elements. If you are doing any example on this program, then you can easily understand. I will show the example also. Just remember how to represent, how to declare the 3D dimensional array. Means here, like that, three slice symbols, rows, columns, and the elements represented in each and every row and column, like this. Okay, I will show an example, you can understand easily. Guys, remember here, actually we can represent the data in the arrays in form of three types. First one is a one dimensional, second one is a two dimensional, and the third one is a multi-dimensional or three dimensional, more than three dimensional. Okay, so one dimension already we have represented and we have seen in previous example. Okay, two dimensional means you are representing the data in the form of rows and columns you can take, and three dimensional also you can represent the rows and columns, but multiple rows and multiple columns like that you can take. So these are the different types of arrays also. And sometimes they will ask the questions, explain about different types of arrays like that. So you have to explain one dimensional array with example, two dimensional array with example, three dimensional array with example. Example means first you have to represent the syntax. After syntax, give small example. Same like that, 2D and 3D also. Okay, here how to initialize the data for multi-dimensional arrays. Just see here, I am initializing the data for two dimensional arrays. How I am initializing? With using both sizes, means 2 and 3. Two and three means two rows here. Two rows, each row consists of three elements. 1, 2, 3 elements, it by using the curly brace. Okay, so here same like that, this is the one set. How many sets? Two sets. Each set consists of three elements. Okay, do you understand? Each set, two sets, one, two sets. How many elements for each set? Three sets. So this is the meaning. You can represent without initializing any size previously. You can directly, as in the elements already previous class also we have discussed, without giving any size you can also give the elements. When the compiler is reading that array, based on that elements it can assign the size of array. Okay, same like this here. How many sets are there? Two sets. Okay, what are the element, how many elements for each set? Three elements. So 1, 2, 3 elements I am giving. Next, same like this, you can give like this also directly without separating. 130 minus 125, it will take the separately two rows and three columns like this. So you can initialize any of them among these three. Okay, any of them among these three you can initialize, or you can assign the arrays data in your program. So then what is the initialization process for 3D arrays, three dimensional array? So here 2, 3, 4. So see here, first from here to here one set, and from here to here two sets. So two sets I am taking. Each set consists of three sets again. These two sets consist of three sets again. These three set, each set consists of four elements. Are you clear? Just I am explaining, I am repeating again. Total these are the, I am dividing those elements two parts. Each part consists of three subparts. Each subpart consists of four elements. Okay, so this is the meaning. First, up to here one set, from here to here, here up to here one set. Okay, so in that sets we have three subsets. Each subset consists of four elements. Same like that, I am entering total how many? Up to here 4 into 3, 12, total 24 elements I can assign here. Here how many elements? 6, 2 into 3, 6 elements I can assign here. So this is the process of declaration of an array in multi-dimensional arrays. These are the arrays very useful in your C programming language for doing different operations. Let's see here one of the example, sum of two matrices. So here I am adding two matrices by using arrays. This is a very important program. Already I have given in your mid exams also. So please be focused. I can explain here each and every line how you are taking the matrices. Here sum of two matrices. This is the matrices order of 2 by 2 means two rows and two columns. So what is the size of the array here? For example, if you are taking any array name with two rows and two columns, how many matrices you have to take? A matrices one thing, and same like that B matrices two rows and two columns. So we know already what is the order for adding two matrices, multiplication two matrices. We have some orders, we have to follow the order, then you can do the operation sub particularly. So this is the A, okay, this is the A and this is the B, and these two matrices I am adding, that is C. So C also consists same two matrices, I mean two rows and two columns. So totally I am taking three matrices. So here let's see, I am taking the data type float, each and everything in a float. One matrix is the A, second matrix is the B, and result is in C. You can take C as also. Each and every matrix consists the rows 2 and columns 2. Then I am taking the inputs through user. Means you can enter the inputs when the program is running. Already yesterday I have given an example. I mean previous class I have given an example how to give the elements into an array. When you are giving the more than one element in your array, you have to use the for loop. Don't forget, already yesterday, I mean previous class, we have seen that thing. So for example, you have five elements, you can start your for loop because of you are entering the values in the index of that array. So your values are storing the array index value. The index of the array will be start from zero. Already we have discussed. Okay, same thing here I am doing. Enter the elements for first matrix. I am entering the elements into first matrix. How many elements I am entering here? Only two elements because of 2 by 2 matrix. So here 2, this is for rows and this is for columns. So first, when I equal to 0, I is equal to 0, correct? So I am entering into the second loop. If the second loop is correct, again j is equal to 0, j less than, then I am going to here, what is this, enter I plus 1 comma j plus 1, okay, enter I plus 1 comma j plus 1, what enter I plus 1 comma j plus 1, here the values of I plus 1 j plus 1 is showing here, and you can enter the value I j values here, floating point like this. Okay, are you understand? Will show what is I value here, 0. What is the Z value here, 0. So 0 0 place, I means index I 0 and J 0 index means A of 0 0, you are entering a value, some value like this 3. So after this thing I am again repeating this loop because of this is the inner loop. First completing the these inner loop, you can go to again previous loop. Okay, next I am incrementing the value j. J is equal to 1. 1 is greater less than 2, correct? Again I am adding here 1 comma 2, 1 2. What is I value here? 0. I value is 0 because of I value is I didn't enter into this loop. I am working this loop first. What is the I value? 0 1. So after 0 1, where the 0 1 index, you are entering some value here. Now for example 4 I am entering like this. Again I am incrementing 2. 2 is less than 2, failure, I mean the loop is failed, and again I am going to upper loop. What is upper loop? I am incrementing the value I value. What is I value? I am incrementing up to 1. So 1 less than 2 correct. Again it is starting from j equal to 0. J less than 1 means 1, 0 I am going. Next again 1, 1 I am going. 1, 1. After failing ring it is going to 2. 2 is less than 2. So both are false. So I am existing from this loop. So I am going to next lines. So this is the entering process of the rows and columns. First you have to check the row position, column position, means 0, 0. Next 0, 1. 0, 1. Same like that. 1, 0, 1, 1. So this is the logic only for implementing this thing. Just don't focus on this thing. You can confuse if you are doing this thing. Okay, just remember only here. Let's see here. Taking the input using nested for loop for second matrix. Same. Second matrix also, I am taking I equal to something, j equal to value, same. Why I am taking less than 2? Because I am entering only 2 values. Here, I am entering the values into b. Here, same logic like previous a. Okay, now I have to add, I am entered here 2 matrices a and b. What is the next step? I have to add those two matrices. What is the result I am getting from this adding? I am storing into another matrix. Here, adding from two arrays. For here, when you are adding or when you are changing into another position also, you have to take the for loop. First, I equal to 0, j equal to 0. So what is the a I 0, j also 0, 0 0 value, what is the a 0 0 value, p 0 0 value. Are you understanding what is the I j values here? First I value 0 and j value also 0, I value 0, j value 0. Okay, so first you are entering 0 0 value plus and b 0 0 value. So 0, 0 is the index here. What are the values are stored in that index? You can add here first. Next, I am repeating this loop because of this is inner loop. First, you have to complete the inner loop. If inner loop is fails, then you can go into outer loop. Okay. So next, j, I am incrementing j. J is less than 2. What is the j value here? 1. So a of 0, 1. A of 0, 1. You are adding into next element plus b of 0, 1. A of 0, 1, B of 0, 1. Again, 2. 2 is less than, so fail. Again, I am going to outer loop. What is outer loop? I am incrementing the value. I is equal to 1 because of I plus plus here. 1 is less than 2. Again, 1. What is the J value starting from 0 again? 1, 0. So 1 here and 0 here plus. What is the I value? 1, 0. Next 1, 1 and 1, 1. So A of 1 and B of these two matrices values based on that index, I am adding in the same position of index values. Just remember, what is the I value, J value when you are adding A of I, J initially? 0, 0. So when you are in 0, 0 values, here I am adding to the same position of that 0, 0. Okay. This is the logic for addition of two matrices. So this is the logic for entering the matrices in by two matrices. Okay, based on that situation. Next, how to display the values in the matrix. You are added in this matrix. I want to display this matrix. So already yesterday also we have discussed how to print the values. When you are printing a value from an array, you have to use the for loop because of you are printing one by one value in the thing based on that index. So index you have to print one by one. So you can use for loop. Same like here, print some of the matrix I am printing where the result is stored here. I j, result of I j. So first I am taking again for loop for I and j. Why I and j? For representing index values of I j. First, what is I value? 0. J value 0. What is the 0 0 value here? Something value I am printing. What is the 0 1 value? I am printing something value. What is the 1 0 value I am printing something? What is the 1 1 value I am printing something? So if j is equal to 1, print slash n means what is this line representing here? When you are reaching here, j is equal to 1 means here j is equal to 1, you can go to the next line. Means I am printing separately. So this is one row and this is second row. For that purpose, I am writing here slash n. This is the logic for going for next line. Here I am representing the output. Here this is the process for addition of two matrices in your array. So first you have to take the input values. Otherwise you can directly take the input values a of v, for example int a of ij is equal to something values. I mean ij places you can take 3, 4 or 2, 2. You can directly assign the values, no problem. But here I show to you how we can take the values through user or from the keyboard. Okay, otherwise directly you can declare initially when the declaration part, then you can directly initialize the values. You can take that values for addition of that matrix. That is also okay, no problem. Okay, but here represent these logics, how you can enter into the matrix elements, how you can add the matrix of the elements, and how you can print the elements from the matrix. So each and everywhere you have to use the two for loops, one for column and one for row. So this is the row and this is the column. Okay, means you have to represent the index values in your matrix. Okay, so you, based on that situation, you have to use these loops. How many loops? First A, two for loops, B, two for loops, and addition when you are adding for loops. So where you are using these matrices, you have to use that for loop for row and column. Okay, here let's see the output. First A of 1 1, I am entering 2. Actually 1 1 means I plus 1 j plus 1 I have given in printf statement, so that is the thing here. Actually you can remember 0 0 place here. A of 0 0 place is 2, 0 1 is place 0.5, minus 1.1 and 2. I entered. This is the B matrix. Okay, I am adding this matrix. After printing this matrix also you have to use the loops, for loops. This is the one of the example for addition of two matrices. You can follow this example, and one of the main program you have to learn, one of the important program, matrix multiplication by using arrays also. That is also one of the important, already I have given in your mid exams. So please learn yourself, that is, then that will be important. Okay, if you have any doubts, ask me, I can explain again. In next video I will introduce about the structures. Okay, so this is the concept of arrays only. Just remember what is an array, how to declaration, how to declare or how to initialize an array. Next, how to give the inputs through keyboard to array, and how to print the values from array. How many types of arrays? Multidimensional, I mean one dimensional, two dimensional, multidimensional arrays. How you can implement those type of arrays, I have shown one example already by using the matrices addition. So remember this concept only for your main exam. You will get 10 to 15 marks from this array concept only. Sometimes they will ask add two matrices, or for example sometimes they asked about previously they have asked one question, explain different types of arrays with example. So just explain one dimension, two dimension, three dimensional, each dimension you have to explain with one example. Okay, so this is an array concept. Next class I will introduce about structures. So only we have two concepts left, structures and file management based on our BTU syllabus. Okay, after that you have to revise the topics. If you have any doubts, ask me freely anytime. I will solve your problems. Okay, thank you.